You're listening to the Frankie and the Driz Show. Frankie and the Driz serve prison time, and that's where they first met. They've learned their lesson and have a new lease on life and want to share their new positive outlook. Let Frankie and the Driz come in your ears tonight and fill them with positivity.
We're Frankie and the Driz, and we're on with Matthew Lesko, correct?
You bet.
Yeah, yo, Matthew Lesko, you're like my favorite Batman villain.
You are. Right. He loves you, Matthew.
Yeah. Yo, I think that shit you were doing back in the 90s with like the infomercials, like I understand how that was to like throw Batman off.
I was going to say, I bought your book once and
Oh, you're the one.
I didn't know what to do with it. It was big.
Yeah, I understand. That's my insecurity. I just threw volume at people, hoping something would work.
I didn't get any money, though.
It takes work. That's the issue. That doesn't come with the book.
No. Oh. Yeah, but in the book, you promised, like, free money.
Yeah, and the commercial.
Yeah.
You shouldn't have to fucking work for free money. Like, no. If you work, then you're getting paid for working. If it's free money, somebody should just, like, hand it to me.
Hey, yo, Zaya used his book to open up this studio.
Yeah, I lied.
did you get in trouble, or did people buy it a lot?
No, I mean, I never got in trouble. What you do, I mean, you can say anything you want on TV.
Yeah.
You know, you can say anything you want anywhere, as long as you don't take people's money. You know, but if you say things that people don't like, and you don't give them back their money, then you get in trouble. But otherwise, nobody bothers you if you return everybody's money. No, so you could say that's why lawyers say, well, I got to pass this by lawyers and all that. That's nonsense. The government's not going to come after you until they get a lot of problems of people bitching because they don't get their money and you lied to them.
Yeah,
but that's why Batman came after you, because he knew the government wasn't going to do anything.
Did you give their money back?
What's that?
Did you have to give a lot of money back?
I mean, no, it wasn't significant at all. The problem I have is that, I mean, you now media back then was, you know, you had to say everything in 60 seconds or short time, and TV with airtime was, you know, critical and expensive and everything. So the whole point of it is how to get people's attention. And so to me, I know it's like diet books. I mean, everybody promises you lose weight when you do a diet book or what? Nobody loses weight. We all get fatter.
Yeah, so Matthew, did anybody get any actual money from your books?
Oh, shit, yeah. All the time, yeah.
I mean, you know, from, like, the government, like, how did they get money if you basically told me that you were scamming people?
Pardon me? No, I didn't say I was scamming people. You were saying I was scamming people. You said you had to work, so you couldn't do it for free. Like, you couldn't fall asleep and wake up in the morning and get money on your couch, I guess, or something. There may be money in the cushion somewhere, but it doesn't fall in on your couch.
I got a mess in my boxers when I woke up.
It takes effort.
Yeah. Sometimes you wake up like that.
Yeah, but if it's like money from the government, it shouldn't take any effort.
Well, it will take effort, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, once in a while it doesn't. They're the people I put in my infomercial.
The minorities get a lot of money.
Pardon me?
The minorities, they get a lot of stuff handed to them.
Well, I mean, the average, here's what we give out every year. These are just government programs. $2.7 trillion. That's how much is given out this year. Where are you guys, in New Jersey?
No, Pennsylvania.
Oh, Pennsylvania? Really? Where about? I grew up in Wilkes-Barre.
We're out here in Westchester.
Oh, I see. Ah, cool. Well, the average, in Pennsylvania, let's see, where the heck is Pennsylvania? And I got a list, I go through that.
Yeah, it was like a little bit past Philadelphia.
Uh-huh. Yeah, no, I know of it, but let's see, where is it? But it's about $22,360 for every family that the government sends last year. That's how much they sent to everybody in cash. This is called transfer payments. So it's all kinds of things, other for training money, for paying rent, for paying...
I got arrested for transferring a lot of stuff in the 80s.
Yeah. Well, actually, it grows every year. This stuff doesn't
I got
away.
A guy if you need anything, Matthew. He's got a lot
Pardon
of
me?
Good stuff. Coke? You like cocaine?
What about it?
Do you need some? I got a guy. I got a guy that he runs for me all the time. Sometimes he goes out west.
Yo, what the fuck, man? We just got out of jail for that shit.
I also wanted to ask about businesses, because I had a couple, and these guys ran it into the ground. I had a couple businesses I funded a couple years ago.
Me and Cheese didn't run that
business. No, that was not you. It was another guy named Wavy, and the Driz was trying to compete with him, but these guys both fucked up, and I want my money back. I wanted to know, how can I get my money back?
What, from people running cocaine?
Yeah, no. It wasn't anything
said.
Like that. No.
So
Frankie claims that he helped him, but I did it by myself. He just fucking copied me and sold my idea to somebody else. But so, like, I run this company called Drizzlebees, and what we are is, like, we're this stand. I set up a stand outside of Applebee's.
Yeah.
And when you get food from Applebee's, you can come out to me, and I'll drizzle, like, fucking chocolate syrup and shit, or whatever you want, all over your food.
Cool.
Maybe maple syrup. Yo, whatever you want. I
but
drizzle. That's why I'm called the Driz.
Yo,
shut the fuck up, Frankie. So Frankie's a fucking asshole because he stole my ideal and gave it to this fucking guy named Wavy and then tries to claim that he gave it to me, and that's not how it worked. But we're kind of cool. Like, we do a show together, obviously, and, like, we did jail time together. I'm not going to tell you why I was in jail.
I raped him in jail a couple times.
Yo, that shit didn't happen.
And I just want my fucking money back.
I mean, you gave him money, too? I thought you knew him well.
But I raped him, also.
Yeah, he didn't fucking rape me.
I also made him a rapper. He's a rapper, and he does a lot of raps on the
YouTube. It's like, stop fucking trying to take credit for my shit. All right, I did this by myself. Just stop. I don't even know why we do a show together, because I'm always fucking arguing with this guy, because he's a fucking dick. But listen, what was your fucking name again? I don't even know. Lesko, Riddler, Enigma, 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 what was it? Edward. Listen, Edward. All right, Edward. Like, how do I, like, I need free money to make my 25th album. Because I ran out of money because the other albums didn't do too well.
He sucks.
Yo, I don't suck. I'm fucking great.
I mean, there's a number of ways, you know, that you may get money. I mean, what you have, actually right there in Philadelphia, you know, there's an office that the government gives money to the University of Pennsylvania there to give you free management consulting, like, to take that.
Whoa! Motherfucker! You've been talking shit about me.
Who's that? It's Waving.
Cool. I'm the one that started Drizzlebees, motherfucker.
Yo, fuck
I'm
you!
The one, dude.
Fuck you! You fucking asshole! You
idea,
did no. First of all, how can you claim that you fucking started Drizzlebees when you have a Wavelbees across the street from my fucking Drizzlebees? So you didn't start Drizzlebees, and I am the Driz. I am the Driz.
Oh, you stole my idea, bitch. We went on that together. Whoa.
Yeah, we wouldn't own shit together. You fucking stole my idea. I did Drizzlebees where I set up outside of fucking Applebee's.
Money, bro.
Yo, I got another caller here. Hi, who's this?
Don't trust this slippery shit, bro. This guy's a lying piece of shit, bro.
Hey, guys.
Ron Burlington's a child molester.
Sorry.
Yo, don't talk that shit about fucking Ron. Is this Heavy Pubes' child? Yo, why the fuck is Heavy Pubes' kid always calling?
Can we do a song? Can we do a song?
Did that bastard Wavy just come?
I just want to come on and do a song with you, Driz.
Oh, yeah, I'm always down for that. What do you need, Matthew?
I'm Shawnee.
I don't know what it is. You guys are having fun. Okay, have a good day.
Yo, Matthew, are you better than, like, the your infomercials were better than that other dude? What was that guy, like, the fucking he a thousand shit? You were better.
Okay, I want to
do
song.
I want to do.
You were, like, okay. Way before the snuggle, buddy.
I want you guys. I want to play.
I love you, Edward Nigma. Yo.
I think Johnny Bowie.
So I just wanted to let everybody know that Edward Nigma hung up.